Hello, aloha, everyone.
Aloha, good morning, metta, good afternoon, mudita, good evening.
So just maybe take a look at each other this morning before we start in, just to say hi and feel the metta, the support. If you want, nobody's, I know if you don't want to do that, that's fine. So many people in so many different places. It's really amazing. And then there's in Japan, it's still dark. It's so cool. East Coast, North, South, West Coast, Mexico. So feeling as we switch to sitting, letting the attention settle into the ecology of your body sensations, the process of knowing we're breathing. Just letting the experience of seeing everyone and the support of that, the kindness of that, seep in to your cells and bones. And as we're offering the teachings with the Brahma Viharas, we start with the Vipassana first. So let's say you came to your eyes now. Seeing is happening even if the eyes are closed. And just noticing if there's any tension, tightness. And you might notice warmth or coolness, soft, smooth, rough, dark shadows, light shadows. And then if you feel inclined, we can incline toward compassion, caring about any tightness there, tension, or striving, kind of reaching the amount that we reach out there to make objects. Just letting the attention settle there, relax. Care about feeling any kind of kindness, tenderness. We often forget how visual we are really trained to be. And because we have such a training to that be such a predominant sense door, sometimes it's helpful to let this part of our body, this part of the universe, know that we appreciate all this work they do. As you know you're hearing, as you notice the sensations right in the moment as they're coming and going, Just see if you can bring some appreciation there. It can be in the cells there, infusing that part of our body with gratitude or appreciation. It doesn't have to be long, it can be a few seconds, just letting that part of us know we care, appreciate. It can shift to a quiet abiding with just that connection without controlling. Sometimes sounds call our attention. At first, just knowing hearing's happening can be the crackling of silence. It has a sound. Check if you're receiving any sound, vibration, texture, movement, just as it's happening, concurrent. Can be more like listening to a symphony or music, or one sound might call and you just let the attention stay right with that sound until it, you notice it vanish. Then if you incline in any way that way, just as we did with our eyes, just noticing sensations in the ears. Or sounds that are happening. But it's just that kindness, caring for any pain, there's many unpleasant sounds. Mostly we're just trying to say thank you. Appreciation. Letting that appreciation sink in non-conceptually. Just letting it infuse the ears. And we'll do the nose and tongue taste together. They're very related. But sometimes not. This feeling, or directly experiencing the sensations in your nose. Smell is happening all the time. the movement of the breath there. The mouth, the tongue is tasting all the time, receiving sensations there. Find your way with this as you're inclined, care, kindness. If ever there's an unpleasant smell or taste, can we care about it? Kindness and that simple thank you. Being able to smell and taste. It's a relationship of appreciation we can cultivate. Because we're in the head area, just let the attention go where you notice thinking. To where we notice thinking. It can be inside the upper part of our head or in front of our eyes, above our head. Just spatially. One can care for thinking itself. And a great compassion. How fast it is. Letting it, this kindness or care, seep in to that part of the body and universe. We're usually very thirsty there and don't know it. Appreciating that we can think. Having a relationship with the thinking of that simple thank you. Receiving gratitude there. The Buddha taught we can understand the whole universe through our fathom-long body. A gift to appreciate in itself. So if you can and want to incline toward this fellow long body in this way, you can just start with your hands that connect us so much with our world, body sensitivity. Noticing the sensations there. Not past memory. At times, if you can, without the visual image. The symphony of aliveness. Letting the care, kindness, appreciation, seep in. Receiving the thank you. And you can continue with your whole body. Or not, you can just shift to anchoring that rhythm, sixth sense door, moment to moment awareness without the anchoring. Anchoring when you need to. Whichever way you're inclined. With this great quiet abiding. one of the important aspects of practicing the Brahma Viharas and the way that we're offering the teachings with the Vipassana is that the Vipassana is like the base of how we begin these practices in the way we're offering them. So for example, with our hand, it could be that we start with a very conceptual perspective of this is my hand, right? And I'm going to practice Vipassana and then some mudita, right? Like it, but it's like what we're saying is however you start, you start with bringing the attention into the hand area. So technically, rather than think hand area, that's why I kept saying that this part of the universe rather than my hand, my body. And we know that if you looked at your hand with a very powerful microscope, you would see all these changing particles, right? Like a lot of space. If you looked with a thermal kind of microscope, you'd see all kinds of temperatures, right? And colors. So this is, I'm not trying to go into this too much right now, but just to remember that rather than just with the visual image, you try to drop in and receive the experience directly, the changing sensations, so that there's an understanding that we're not being kind toward a me or an I or mine. We might start there. So you're not rejecting that concept or that duality, but the attempt is to bring the attention is in and investigate first and to notice. Maybe you notice heaviness and that's earth element. So you start to shift to like, oh, there's this changing process of earth, air, fire, and water. And sometimes we might be actually caring for this changing process itself or appreciating that we can borrow earth element or air element, fire element, right, water element, that it's extraordinary that we can take a breath and think it's ours, but actually if it's cold outside and you look carefully, you see that you can see there that the breath is air and it's coming in, going out, but it's not ours. And that this investigation in relationship to the sort of non-conceptual reality and the non-conceptual care, kindness, appreciation, we're just encouraging you and inviting you to also remember to explore on that level when you're standing, walking, eating, that of course sometimes it will be conceptual, but if you have enough energy and space and time, you know, this is it, Saturday, Sunday, you know, we have that momentum behind us. Try to take the time sometimes, if there's not too much resistance, to really get the sense that the practice is really investigating who am I on a very deep level and that the Brahma Viharas can seep into that wisdom. It's, we can all do that. We can do it. And the other thing I wanted to mention is just, you know, just to be careful of getting sucked into the future like a vacuum. Just try to, when you notice the attention kind of getting drawn, just bring it back gently to now and start again. That real courage and inspiration to really trust your practice and appreciate all that you've given into it, but to express that appreciation by keeping going. You don't have to step on the gas, but you don't have to step on the brake right now. You could step on the gas. You don't have to. That's it. There's interviews today, so please, if you haven't checked. And Jesse or Steve or Dorina, any more announcements or anything?
Yeah, just a little bit about to just remind folks to take a look at the bulletin board on the Academy website. There's a few just details about today and tomorrow, basically. Just so everyone knows, tomorrow's schedule is designed to be basically the same. You know, it'll have all of the primary sittings that we have on every other day. We'll include an 11 a.m. Q&A session for the part-time yogis again, so for whoever might be interested in that. And then at the 2 o'clock, which will be the kind of closing talk and closing, we'll still do the metta afterwards. There's an invitation to everyone else, you know, the full-time yogis, that if you have a question you'd like us to address, you can email it to the information at Vipassana Hawaii address. That's all on the bulletin board, so you should just see it there. But if there's any kind of questions about your practice or about the Dharma or Buddhism or about future, you know, how to integrate, that kind of thing, you can send a question by email to us anytime before tomorrow morning, and we'll try to incorporate it into our offering. And then just, yeah, today's the last round of individual interviews, so please double check that just to make sure you're in the right place at the right time.
Yeah, so enjoy your practice, you know, like try to at times, you know, see if you can appreciate this space that we have to practice together. It's a rare for human beings to get this kind of space and time together. Thank you. So good to see everybody.